Welcome back to the Old Guy Network. I am the old guy, the OG. Jay, you know who the hell you are. Well, the first thing I want to do is thank everybody for tuning into the Dumpster Diving Sunday. I say it was a great success. You know, if you look at it, we got a couple hundred views. Hey, that's good for me. Usually I get between 30 and 50 views on a video. So, hey, I'm doing pretty good on that. So thank you very much for doing that. Look forward, please look forward to another one like me. We're going to have another one this Sunday. Zane and I will be diving in the dumpsters once again in the and traveling around the trailer park in the, the dumpster diving mobile. So thanks again. I really do appreciate that. A couple of other things I want to mention first. I can't find my real glasses, so I've got these. And yeah, they're hot glued together. Because that's the way it is in an old guy's world. The second thing I wanted to mention was something that actually happened a couple of weeks ago. I was putting together some flags, and I used different stains with the flags, red, white, and blue, of course. And I just want to show you what happens when you close the lid of a blue stain can and hit it with a hammer. You get this. Yep, that's what happens, and as you can see, I'm not real happy about that, so, yeah, you shouldn't do that. It, one of my friends saw that. I put the picture on Facebook, she saw it, and said, "Oh, look, you're a Smurf," and I said, "No, I'm not a Smurf. Look closely. I'm a Blue Jay." I know, that's bad. But, yeah, be very careful when you're putting the lid back on stain, because it gets in your beard, your mustache, and whatever else you have. Yeah, what a mess to clean up. But yeah, you know, everybody makes mistakes. Me, just like everyone else. You know, happens. But today I've got something a little special for you. I want to have a garden here in the park. A couple of restrictions that we have here is you can have a garden, but you cannot dig in the dirt. I know that sounds kind of weird. So you have to have a raised garden. You have to build your own platforms, put dirt in it, and that sort of thing. Well, I don't want to do that. That's too permanent for me. What if I put it in the wrong spot, don't get enough sun, or I get good sun now but not good sun later? I like to have my options open and be able to move my garden when I want to. So that's what the next video, this video right here, that's what this is all about. So let's get started. After I get this cleaned up a little bit, we're going to start on another project. It is springtime, almost summer. Summer's on the way. Spring means flowers and vegetables, vegetable gardens, that sort of thing. And I'm going to show you how I'm going to plant a garden this year and how I'm going to dress it up to make it look a little better than it should. But man, there's a lot of stuff that has to come out of here. So I'm going to clean this mess up and then we'll get started. And just like that, a few things are put away. not a great deal, but a few things. I can at least get around now. This is going to be my garden right here. This is a pickle barrel, or a pickle bucket, 5 gallon. A friend of mine works in a restaurant. He's one of the managers, and he brought this over for me to get me started. Hopefully I'll get a few more of these. Even if I have to buy these to have my little garden, it's okay, because you can buy Homer buckets at Home Depot for like $4, something like that. You don't need covers, so they're fairly cheap. And what we're going to do is eventually I'm going to put some gravel in this, some compost and potting soil, along with some good old-fashioned dirt. When you're doing one of these plants and using this as a planter, you can't just put potting soil in it, because it's not very dense material. There's not a lot of drainage, and the water just builds up, it compacts, and it just makes a mess. So you have to thin out the soil a little bit, put some gravel in, put some rocks in the bottom, and then you can have proper drainage. Now, also to have drainage, we've got to drill some holes, and everything that I've read said about 3 inches apart at the bottom. So we're just going to drill some quick holes in it, and then we'll be ready to start. Thank you.
if you're lucky enough to get these for nothing, you get a pickle barrel like I did, these pickle buckets. One good tip for you is do not open up the pickle bucket in your house because it will smell like pickles for quite a while. If you like the smell of pickles, great. If not, well, then you're going to have a problem. So open it up outside. I probably should have told you that before. Got our holes. Now gravel will go in here, and then a mixture of compost, dirt, and potting soil will go over that. That's simple. That's easy. Now, after we get that done, and we've put our plant in here, and I've already got plants started, sooner we put the plants in here, the nice thing about having this is I can move it. It's got a handle. If I'm not getting enough sun someplace, I can move it to another place. I could even move it every day if I wanted to. I can put it in the sun in one area. I can bring it over to another area as the sun goes down. That's the good part about this. The bad part is you got a white bucket. And if you're using the Homer buckets from Home Depot or anywhere else, you got an orange bucket. And that doesn't look all that great. So I've got an idea to dress this up a little bit and still be able to move it and store what I'm going to do very easily. And it's very simple, very, very simple. I'm gonna make the whole thing out of 100% pallet wood. So yeah, let's do that. First thing we're gonna do, measure out our bucket. Now make sure you measure from the handle, the ends of the handles out, so you have enough room. And we add just a little bit. That's about 12 inches, 12 and a half inches. So let's go 13 inches, and that will give us enough room to hide the handle too when we're all done. So 13 inches around, and our bucket is about 14 and a half inches, so we'll go up to 16 inches.
Full stop. Don't go by my dimensions. In my head, I changed the dimensions on the inside of the bucket, the inside of the planter. Listen, I don't know what size bucket you're using. Don't use my dimensions. Measure them out for yourself, because instead of 13 inches, I actually made the braces 14 inches, and I changed everything, but I didn't explain that, so let's get back to the video.
So if we're making this 16 inches high, that means we need 16-inch boards. These are a lot more than that, actually. This one here is about 37 inches. That means we can do two boards with just one of these. So I'll be cutting these in half, and then you'll get a better idea of just what we're doing. So there we have our pieces all cut out, 16 inches, pretty sweet, and as you can see there's three to each side, so we've got 12 pieces there, that'll take care of that, except for the pieces we're going to put in between, and I'll explain that in a few minutes. Right now we're going to make some braces. We're going to make them 16 inches long, and no we're not, we're going to make them 14 inches long, there we go, and probably half the width of one of these boards. That on that saw. I'll be right back. You don't need to see that. 14 inches. Okay, and those are our pieces over here, and those are our braces over here, and now we're just going to put them together. This is the fun part. Because these aren't structurally holding anything, there's no pressure on these, they're not holding dirt in or anything. All they are is just a shroud around the bucket. So I'm just going to use some wood glue and some brad nails from my brad nailer and just tack these together. Two up here, two down there, that makes four. Now we're just gonna pre-drill some holes on the side. And I'm just gonna do two sides at a time just to show you how we put these together. Oh, let's get way back there. Okay, so I'm gonna drill probably a hole here and then another hole here. And then we'll put in deck screws and I'll show you what it looks like.
Did I say deck screws? No, I'm not using deck screws. That'd be a waste of money. I'm just using cheap drywall screws. Because this is, you know, this is not something that has to last forever. Now, you'll notice, too, that I did the rough side out. It's a lot smoother on this side. We could have just sanded it, but I want it to look rough. I want it to look rustic. And, you know, we don't have to try so hard on this. So, I've already pre-drilled my holes. I've got a screw there and a screw there. And basically, yeah, this is the best way to do it, I guess. All right, now, like I said before, we're gonna stagger these. So if the edge of this board here is up against here, we're gonna do the same thing over here. We're gonna drop drills on the floor. And this is why I only use DeWalt and Bostitch, because I drop them all the time, and those are the two brands that really seem to hold up. So when we do this again, we're going to do the same thing. That way, if this board is going up against here, like that, this board over here is not. It's on the side. You do that, so you'll still have 14 inch or 16 inches around. Okay, you got that? Trust me, it works. And there you have it. Now, let me show you the staggering thing I was talking about here. Let's put this down. This board butts up against this board. That means this board butts up against this board. This one butts up against this one, and so on and so forth. That way, they're all, it's a square box, or fairly square. Look at that. That's it. Now when you see this, you won't see the bucket, you'll just see this box. And as you can see, if I need to move it, I can just reach right in, grab the handle, pull out my clamps, move the box, put it back. The only cost I have in this is a little bit of glue, a few brad nails from my brad nailer, and a few cheap drywall screws. That's all I have. Now, yeah, this is not gonna last for 100 years. We could seal it, we could paint it, we could make it look really, really pretty. I'm just trying this out for this year. I don't even know if I'm going to do this again next year. To me, this is just, you know, it's just one of those things. I wanted to hide the bucket and not really pay anything for it. I've got less than, what, a quarter in this? Maybe 50 cents? I don't know, because the wood was all free. Now, what I might do is put a trim on the top. Yeah. I think I'll do that. Okay, just to pretty this up just a little bit, I've got some of these left over, so I'm gonna put these down like that. I'll cut them to the right size and put that down there and just make a nice little lip around there. So I'm gonna do that, pre-drill the holes, and then secure them to the box.
And there, that looks a little better.
Yeah, I like that little edge.
Let's get that up higher so I can see it.
There we go.
Well, yeah, what's wrong with that? Didn't take very long. Hides the bucket. And it's reusable. And all I have to do at the end of the year, if I want to keep this at the end of the season, I just take out the screws because there's no glue on the sides and just stack it up underneath the bench or against the wall or under my bed, wherever I want to put it. Or it can end up in somebody's bonfire. Either way, didn't cost very much to make and it looks pretty cool.